Welcome. This segment in the Soil Health, a Montana Perspective video series will provide a general overview of the soil health topic and the other segments in the series. Agriculture is the number one industry in Montana, and the soil is a key component of crop production. Despite the importance of soil, we have taken it for granted for many years. We have looked at the soil simply as the medium that plants grow in. Perhaps it's time we start thinking about the long-term quality and well-being of this important asset. In other words, thinking about soil health.
We've been incorporated for 96 years, and what we're trying to do is figure out how to operate for another 100 years. And we feel that soil health is one of the areas that we have to pursue if we're going to do that.
For many years, crop production has emphasized planting crops, fertilizing, controlling weeds and pests, and harvesting crops. Each year at harvest time, we see what happened above ground, but what's going on beneath the surface is not so obvious. Changes in soil health are hidden below ground and often go unnoticed. Is it really necessary to consider the health of your soil for crop production? With all you have to think about and plan for in farming, planting dates, which crops or varieties to grow, weather, weeds, prices, and much more, why would a producer want to add yet another consideration? Because gradual changes below ground eventually affect what grows above ground.
Producers want to consider improving their soil health because it leads to greater soil microbial activity, greater soil water infiltration, increased water holding capacity in the soil, and increased organic matter levels within the soil.
This will affect crop production, yields, and profitability in the long term. This is not something that will happen overnight or from one year to the next.
It takes patience, but we need to do this because we can't sustain this constant tillage.
Positive changes to soil health are possible when some general principles for improving soil quality are incorporated into agricultural management practices in an ongoing management system. First, minimize soil disturbances, especially tillage. Undisturbed root systems are the main contributor to increased organic matter levels in the soil and the building of soil structure. Second, provide soil cover by reducing disturbance and planting crops that are slow to break down. Residue is important, and it is a key component of a system grounded in soil health. Third, increase crop diversity by varying crop types within your rotation and/or using a cocktail mix as a cover crop. Fourth, increase soil microbial activity by keeping living roots in the soil as long as possible. Soil microbes feed on sugars that leak from the plant roots. Lastly, incorporate livestock whenever possible to add another component of diversity to your system. Many of us have heard of these ideas working in other parts of the country, but is it really possible in Montana? The answer is yes. These principles of soil health can be adapted for use in all environments, and they can be further adapted to individual producers' goals, objectives, and resources. Some Montana farmers and ranchers have been using these principles to build soil health. Experienced Montana practitioners can show all of us how they do it in their operations, recount mistakes they have made, tell us what has worked and what hasn't, and describe what benefits they are seeing from managing their system for soil health. Other segments in this video series feature interviews with some of these people.
I guess you really switch your mentality to thinking about what your decisions are, how they're impacting the living things in the soil every month of the year.
To Montana's agricultural industry, improving soil health can mean 1. Reduced runoff and increased water infiltration, greater available water holding capacity in the soil, and improved soil structure. All of this means more water available to the growing crop, which should mean higher crop yields and quality. 2. Improved nutrient cycling, added carbon and nutrients, increased organic matter, and much more. A truly healthy soil can do more than just support crop production. It can make more nutrients available to the growing crop and possibly decrease dependency on commercial fertilizers. In order to see these improvements, we must improve soil health. We know that we can improve soil health if we use 4 primary conservation practice tools. These tools are no-till, crop rotation, cover crop, and grazing. In following video segments, we will explore these tools individually. For more information about soil health, visit your local USDA service center or go to www.nrcs.usda.gov.